So, buenos días, señor.
Buenos días, Peter. How are you? Nice to see you again in Munich.
You too.
How was your experience in Lebanon?
Oh, it was exciting. Very good. And you know, here at the Munich show, to find one piece that would fit in the museum is not so easy, you know?
Not easy at all.
Not easy. And you have to go and see the collection. The interesting thing is everybody are asking about the... Yeah. They're asking how, where to go and see. Can we go and see the museum?
Yeah, yes.
Is there any hotel nearby?
Yes. And I know. I was invited, but unfortunately, Munich show was so close that
I need
to prepare everything. I have a large booth and I had no chances. But of course, I will do it.
So you have some new things, some new finds.
Yes, please follow me. They are all on the table. First, probably the more exciting one are
Germany.
The new hydroboracites. They come out past year from that quarry.
Yeah. Get that like that.
But the quality from the find in November 2012 is even better and higher than the former ones. Looks the quality, the gemminess.
Yeah, the beautiful one.
The perfection.
Very lustrous.
So it's not only very good from Germany, but also for any other hydroboracites. Even Iranian ones are good, as you know, but not so large and probably not so gemmy.
Those are beautiful, really gemmy.
I'm very happy with.
You have
here
a big group.
Yes, I can show you another one, more spectacular by the size, and also because it's related with gypsum, so you can see the gypsum crystals here, but the hydroboracite standing up, it looks like a mesolite or a zeolite.
Here you see the gypsum on the side here. That's beautiful.
Yeah, hyper quality for the species.
And you know, now we're talking about a new find November a year ago.
Yes, in November a year ago.
Yes.
In the past Munich show, they was offered for first time. It was one of the success of the show.
Yes.
But the quality of the new find in November after Munich show, it's in my opinion a little bit higher than the first ones.
Yeah.
So we are very happy with this material. The first find and the second one, both.
Very good.
Very nice material. That is an example of the fabulous carrolites mined, as everybody knows, in 2002 in Congo. This is not the real best, but it's a good example of the fantastic quality of something that you remember the Belgium collectors having the small crystals in his collection.
I have the best piece from his collection, Monsieur Pondeville.
Exactly.
I got all his best miniatures, and that was the best carolite in the world.
It was like this.
It's still very, very good, but not the size.
But right now they found something really exciting in terms of size. Complex crystallography, some pieces of matrix, and the luster. Looks the luster. It's great, no?
Monsieur Pondeville, he was ill in cancer just before he passed away, and he got one of the giant ones, the best one.
Yes.
At the time.
Yeah, and comparing with the small one he has, you know, it's like a miniature comparing with a big monster. Yeah, I remember
that. And you have a Spanish piece here, I see.
Yes, sir. This is a very fine fluorite from a new quarry in Spain, and that is in a private property. It's not really a quarry. It's someone following a former phylon of fluorite.
Yes.
And he's making holes in his own property to find fluorite.
That's wonderful. The quality is super.
Yeah, the name of the quarry is Llamas.
Yes.
The locality close is Duyos. And it is not an operating area. It's just someone digging in his own property and finding fluorites. So imagine, Peter, if you have that in your home, and in the weekends you make a hole and you find that.
That's beautiful.
It's not exciting.
Very nice.
I would love to have this property myself, as you can imagine.
Trade his house and property.
He don't want.
And then we have this crazy new deposit that only started a few years ago producing.
Yes, producing a lot of unbelievable species like the elbites, like the lollingites here, related with octahedral fluorides, the gemmy, the combo, everything is good.
So this is lollingite with a fluorite, and the deposit is Huanggang. It's an iron mine deposit, and it also has a lot of other minerals like beryllium, arsenic, and tin. And there are plenty of pockets. So in fact, just a few years, some people started to call it the new Dalnegorsk with Ilvite and everything. But it has...
It's much more complex.
Much more complex.
Correct.
And it's a huge number of ore bodies, and hopefully they will be mining for many decades to come.
Hopefully. Yeah. It's even very rare minerals like the borcarides. I have one here in some place. Okay, this is the borcarides from the same mine with canite. So both borcarites and kanites are much better than any other borcarite and kanite found before, even from Franklin, Sterling Hill.
Yes, and very well crystallized.
And we don't expect to find in a skarn like Wangang mines something like this. So it's very promising because it means that many other rare species could appear in the future.
Yes.
And we have a lot of chances to see much more unbelievable species on that mine.
And this combination piece is wonderful.
This is a combo of albite. As you know, they should be analyzed because they zone. It could be albite, it could be gentelvite, it could be danalite,
yes.
Which is funny because the more rare on that mine is the danalite, the iron pole.
Yes.
And it is iron mine.
Yes.
But for some reason, the danalite is not frequent.
It didn't make it there. It made it to the magnetite.
Yeah, just few. And this piece is good by the combination with the ilvite crystals.
Ilvite took the iron too, you know.
Quartzes, magnetite.
And the size of it, they are large in Sweden, huge danalite. But helvite in most localities are very small. And these are very good size and such beautiful groups.
The groups.
On a beautiful matrix.
Yeah.
The thing is, if you look at such a mineral as beryllium, there are 111 beryllium minerals on the planet.
Correct.
But if you look back 3 billion years ago, there was just emerald beryl known.
Yeah.
And then in the something that people don't think about, but during the evolution of the Earth, you had a lot of different geological environments.
Correct.
At 1.8, 1.6 billion years ago, we got longbone coming in with a huge number of new species.
Correct.
So today, in recent, if you look at the pegmatites forming in Pakistan, now they're 8 million years old.
Yes.
You have plenty of beryllium. So beryllium is a very rare element that was enriched in the history of the Earth.
Yes. But the funny thing in that mine is that it's a skarn.
Yes.
Rich on beryllium, which is not so common.
Not common.
This is a polpot of many different elements, giving a lot of different species and great ones.
Yeah.
And finally, let me show you what my dog likes. Just a second.
That's your dog likes that one.
This is what my dog likes.
Yeah.
It's the Fidobon. And he take with his... he's the perfect bone for my dog.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's a genial bite, looking like
one.
A bone. And my dog is very happy with it. I am not very happy with my dog when he touched it, but anyway, it's a nice bone.
That's a very sweet piece. Really, really nice.
You
this
seen
is
that?
Crazy new.
Yeah.
One mine.
Yeah.
Producing so many new crazy species.
Yeah, and much better all them of the former ones. Much better than the former ilvites, much better than the albites, much better than the gentelvites, much better than borcarites, etc., etc., etc. The list will be long, I am sure of that.
Golden ages of mineralogy, really. We are
lucky. I agree.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
All the best.
Okay.
See you later at the party.
Thank you. I hope so.